Singapore ministers are being paid too much. Singaporeans are not ready for non-Chinese PM.
Opinion, people are entitled to that view, not covered by this bill.
Foreigners have been brought into Singapore at the expense of locals.
Opinion can continue saying, this is why I say 99% of the time, 99% of the things people say will not be covered by this bill.
Changes to the elected presidency serve the purpose of preventing punching bag from running.
Opinion can continue to say it, not covered by the bill.
Singapore ministers are being paid too much.
Opinion can continue saying it and more, and not covered by the bill.
So all these are opinions and they can be conveyed to people.
Yeah, the bill doesn't cover these sorts of opinions. It deals with factual falsehoods. Like, this building has fallen down. Or, you know, you go to KK Hospital, they will inject you and you will get AIDS. We'll deal with those sorts of statements.
And also, did you take up political office with the ambition that maybe one day you'll be named DPM or even higher?
Politics is not like any other job. It's not just a job. You're coming in order to get some things done, people's lives to be better. If you think of it as a job, you know, I want to get to this position and this position and this position, you will be a very unhappy person, and that's not the purpose of getting into politics.
In 10 years, the pay cut that you took was between 70 to 100 million. Is this true?
You know, the pay cut that I took is public information long ago. It was published in the newspapers. It will be in that order.
Does that happen to be the highest among?
That I don't know. Innocent forwarders, 99% of the time, what do? You know, we receive something, it is interesting, we share, we forward, you don't get into trouble. The worst thing that can happen to you is maybe, you know, you have the clarification pushed down to you to say this is, you know, untrue, then it helps you. In fact, it's like shining a torchlight, you know, it gives you a better understanding of what is true and false. And in some cases, if you are yourself someone who is influential or if there's a reason to do so, then you yourself might be asked to carry a clarification and put it out. After we've seen how falsehoods have been weaponized, how hate speech has been weaponized, and how foreign intelligence agencies use the internet space, we decided, rather than using the broad powers, which have so far been used in the 20-odd years to really deal with child porn, child abuse, you know, that sort of material, we need dedicated legislation. So you would look at this new bill as a subset of the powers. I emphasize lesser powers. A lot of the things in POFMA are not new. In fact, the powers that are given to the government under POFMA are less, I emphasize less, than the powers under the Broadcasting Act. Second, there is greater oversight given to the courts under POFMA compared with the Broadcasting Act. And it's not just the Broadcasting Act, there are other pieces of legislation, Undesirable Publications Act, Telecoms Act. So whatever we wanted to do, most of the essential things we wanted to do, actually there are much greater powers under the Broadcasting Act. So it could have been done under that. So there is a direct appeal on the question of whether it is true or false. You don't have that under the Broadcasting Act. And under the Broadcasting Act, things can be taken down if it is contrary to public interest. Has the government, abused its powers for over 20 years? The government is responsible for day-to-day events. What is the difference? You ask an independent body, then it's got to cover the wide areas which are today covered by the government. So you appoint such a body. Who are they accountable to? Who do they answer to? And actions can be questioned in court. How do you question that in court? Here, the minister is answerable to Parliament. He is answerable to the electorate. It's transparent. And his actions are, he's answerable to the courts.